Hello everyone, I welcome you all to the Infinity Vision platform. Right now I'll be doing one such question that came in your JEE Main examination. This question came on 31st August 2021 in shift 2. So let us see this question first. Question says, a free electron of 2.6 electron volt energy collides with hydrogen plus ion. This results in the formation of hydrogen atom in the first excited state and the photon is released. Find out the frequency of the emitted photon. And the Planck's constant value is also given to you. So that means initially you have been given an electron. Let this be the electron. And an atom of hydrogen atom is also there. H plus ion. So it is devoid of electron. Okay, so let this be H plus ion you have been given. Okay, so this electron is there whose energy is given by a relationship and whose magnitude is 2.6 electron volt, okay, which has been given to you. Okay, obviously if this electron comes to this hydrogen atom, H plus ions, so it will form a hydrogen atom. Okay, at its initial position, both would have a potential energy of zero because the separation between them would be quite infinite. So that means the potential energy of these two systems must be zero. Okay, so the total energy, while they are very much apart at its initial position, was given by total energy is nothing but zero, which is potential plus 2.6 electron volt, which is the energy of electron. Okay, now if they're gonna collide and H plus ion H hydrogen atom is formed, in which electron is there and at its first excitement state. So that means this electron has moved from this particular point to this point. So here n is equal to 1, n is equal to 2, n1 is in, if the electron is in its ground state and it has moved on to, if it is its first excitement state, which is in which the n must be equal to 2. Okay, so this is its ground state and this is its first excited state in which the electron will go. Okay, at its first excited state, the total energy possessed by hydrogen atom is given by relationship E. Suppose this is E initial and this is the E final, which is minus 3.4 electron volt. So this is the energy possessed by a hydrogen atom at its first excited state. Obviously, initially the energy was 2.6 electron volt, now it is minus 3.4 electron volt. So that means there is a loss of energy. So that means electron, while moving from this particular point to this, it will gonna release energy in the form of radiation. Because there is a loss of energy, that loss of energy will be in the form of radiation. Okay, and we also know the relationship. So the change in energy, what would be the change in energy? E final minus E initial. No. Or you can say the total energy released must be equal to, you can easily write it as E initial minus E final. So this much of energy would be released in the form of radiation. So it would be 2.6 electron volt minus of minus 3.4 electron volt. So which is 6 electron volt. So delta E, which is the energy released while forming this hydrogen atom at its first excitement state, is 6 electron volt. Now this energy will be released in the form of radiation. So this must be equal to E is equal to H times frequency. So E is equal to H into frequency. Okay, so this is also one of the such relationship that we already know. So we'll be putting the values and find, we can easily get the expression for frequency of radiation released. So 6 electron volt, 6 is nothing but 1.6 into 10 raised to the power minus 19 joule, because 1 electron volt has a possesses an energy of 1.6 into 10 raised to the power minus 19 joule. So 6 electron would have this much of energy. So this must be equal to H times frequency. Okay, H is a Planck's constant, so frequency would comes out to be 6 into 1.6 into 10 raised to the power minus 19 divided by 6.6 into 10 raised to the power minus 34. So after solving it, you'll be getting a value, and this will go over there. So you'll be getting a value of 1.45 into 10 raised to the power. Okay, so how much you're getting? So it would be close to 15 hertz. So this much of final energy that you are getting, this much of final frequency that you will be getting. Obviously, all the answers are given in megahertz. So it has to be converted into megahertz. So it would be, because 1 megahertz is 10 raised to the power 6 hertz, so it would be equal to 1.45 into 10 raised to the power 9 megahertz. Okay, so this is the final expression that we are getting, which is third. So third would be the correct option. Remember one thing, you have to convert all the energy released in the form of radiations. Okay, and this much of frequency of radiation would be released during this process. Okay, and if electron moves from its first excited states to some another excited states, in that case the energy has to be provided to the system or to the electron or the atoms in order to move into its higher excited states. In this case, the energy would be released. I hope this question is clear to everyone. Thank you.